Good morning. Today we want to see the book of Matthew chapter 14. Matthew chapter 14 from verse 13 to 21. Matthew chapter 14 from verse 13 to 21. I will read. Matthew chapter 14 from verse 13 to 21. I will read. When Jesus heard it, he departed from there by boat to a deserted place by himself. But when the multitudes heard it, they followed him on foot from the cities. And when Jesus went out, he saw a great multitude, and he was moved with compassion for them, and healed their sick. When it was evening, his disciples came to him, saying, "This is a deserted place, and hour is already late. Send the multitudes away, that they may go into the village and buy themselves food." But Jesus says to them, "They do not need to go away. You give them something to eat." And they says to him, "We have here only 5 loaves and 2 fish. He said, "Bring them here to me." Then he commanded the multitudes to sit down on the grass. And he took the 5 loaves and 2 fish, and looking up to heaven, he blessed and broke and gave the loaves to the disciples, and the disciples gave to the multitudes. So they all ate and were filled, and they took up 12 baskets full of the fragments that remained. Now those who had eaten were about 5,000 men, besides women and children. Amen. Today you want to see this the miracle of 5 loaves and 2 fish. And we look at we know this story very well, but then we just want to see this again. Last night I was wondering what I can share today. But then when I was reading the Bible here and there, then just this verse, I thought that just this part will be look to be good for us to share today in the morning. What does this part teach us? We can look at this part from many viewpoints. This part gives us many messages, teaches us many messages. But then today we want to focus on one thing today. When Jesus heard it, he departed from there by boat to a deserted place by himself. When Jesus heard it, then Jesus was sad, and then Jesus maybe wanted to think himself, or Jesus wanted to pray God by himself. Then Jesus went somewhere which is very quiet, which where not many people know. But then what did Jesus hear? When Jesus heard it, what did Jesus hear? As you look at the previous part at John, Matthew chapter 14, Then we can see the news about John the Baptist. John the Baptist got imprisoned and he died there in the prison. John the Baptist. And then after Jesus heard that, then he departed from there by boat to a deserted place by himself. When Jesus heard the news about John the Baptist dying in the prison, then Jesus went to a solitary place, quiet place, to pray God. Who was John the Baptist? Who was John the Baptist? John the Baptist was the one who was supposed to prepare the way for Jesus. John the Baptist was has to prepare the way for Jesus Christ. But then this person, he died in the middle. He couldn't really fulfill all his commission for his life. But he died in the middle. Actually, through John the Baptist, more people could believe in Jesus as Christ or as Savior. But then John the Baptist, as he died in the middle, then could not, the history of salvation, it could not really go faster. John the Baptist, he died in the middle. And then John the Baptist, if John the Baptist could be one with Jesus, could follow Jesus, then maybe more people could believe in Jesus, more people. Because John the Baptist was from the family of the high priest, Zechariah, Elizabeth, the tribe of Levi, or Judah? Levi, right? Levi. John the Baptist had the background of the high priest. The family was the family of high priest. If John the Baptist really deliver or advocate for Jesus, preach about Jesus Christ more, then even among the Pharisees or among the high priests, maybe many of the Pharisees, many of the teachers of the law, even maybe they could believe in Jesus as Christ. But then John the Baptist, as he could not really fulfill all his commission, and then it was very sad. So Jesus has to start from the first. Jesus has to start from the first. Actually, John the Baptist, maybe through those then, they could evangelize, they could bring many people to Jesus. But then, as this person died, then Jesus himself has to go down, Jesus has to start from the first by evangelizing. Did you realize it? As the Pharisees, as the high priests, as they didn't believe in Jesus as a Savior, then that's why Jesus had to use, like these, the people like the stones. Even God raised up these stones to be the sons of Abraham. They were not, who are not educated, who are not really educated with the Word of God. But then Jesus had to teach them from the first. But if Pharisees and teachers of the law, if they could believe in Jesus, they already studied the word of God a lot. Even they were memorizing the word of God a lot. But if they could just believe in Jesus as the Savior, as that Jesus was sent by God, then yeah, the word of God of Jesus, yeah, many more people could really believe in Jesus. More people. But then the sad story is, these religious leaders, Pharisees, and teachers of the law, as they didn't believe in Jesus as a Savior, then Jesus had to start from the first. Jesus had to start from the first. Son of John. Son of John, do you love me? Jesus was calling Peter. Son of John, why did Jesus call Peter son of John? Maybe Peter could be the son of John. Peter has to walk the walk of John, John the Baptist, to prepare the way of Jesus. You have the same commission, son of John. Well, was it Peter's physical father, John? Physical father of Peter was John, the man? You don't know, right? I don't know exactly. But usually people were, Jesus was calling the disciples with some meaning. Son of John, or son of Jonah, sometimes Jesus was calling Jonah, son of Jonah. Jonah was whom? Who was Jesus? I will show you the miracle of Jonah. I will die, I will be in the tomb for 3 days. I will rise up again. The miracle of Jonah, I will show you. I can show you. But anyway, here, when Jesus heard that John the Baptist died in the prison, then he departed from there by boat to a deserted, solitary place by himself. But when the multitudes heard it, they followed him on foot from the cities. And when Jesus went out, he saw a great multitude. And when Jesus wanted to have his own time with God, praying God, maybe, thinking about it, thinking about the ministry, how he can do the ministry from today. As John the Baptist died, maybe Jesus was wondering about it. And he wanted to pray God, having his own time before God. But then, when he went to another quiet place, but many other people already knew where Jesus was going, then many other people was already waiting for Jesus there. Using another mean, on foot, they already went to the Jesus place where Jesus was. And then when Jesus saw them, then he was moved with compassion. Yeah. Jesus was moved with compassion for them and healed their sick. Yeah. It's like another Bible, another book, Mark or Luke. Then Jesus was compassionate. Jesus was somehow, what is it, sad, looking at that people don't look to have the shepherd. They were like the sheep without the shepherd. So then Jesus had the compassion on them. Jesus did not just send them away. Ah, I need to pray, God. Don't come. Don't bother me today. I need to plan. I need to pray, God, and I need to plan again. Actually, Jesus was wanting to pray, God. Jesus had to plan again without John the Baptist. But here, people didn't give Jesus the time, free time. Many people were still following Jesus. Many people. So multitude of people and many sick people. So Jesus healed the sick. And then many people were just looking at Jesus. Many people were just hearing, listening to Jesus. Until when? Until evening. So that's how people were hopeless. Many people were hopeless, or many people wanted to find the hope for their life through Jesus. That's why many people were listening to Jesus until evening. And then verse 15, when it was evening, his disciples came to him saying, "This is a deserted place, and the hour is already late. Send the multitudes away, and they may go into the villages and buy themselves food." Yeah, that was the common sense. The disciples, yeah, because there were so many people, yeah, they could not really feed all the people. It was not like just 12. It was not like 20 or 30. It was more than that. Bible said it was more, 5,000 men. Men only was around 5,000. So many people were there. So Jesus' disciples said to Jesus, "We need to send them away. It's already evening time, night. It becomes night. And they should be hungry. We don't have enough money." It's true. Could they really have that much money to feed 5,000 people or 20,000 people, including the children and women? Yeah, they could not. So the disciples said to Jesus, "We need to send them home, or we need to send them away, so that they can solve their problems by themselves." But verse 16, "But Jesus says to them, 'They do not need to go away. You give them something to eat. You give them something to eat. You give them something to eat.'" What is it? Were they the people, the God, or the disciples of Jesus, guardians of the people? Were the disciples of Jesus, did they really have the responsibility to take care of the people physically? Yeah. They didn't have the responsibility, right? Even the disciples of Jesus, they were not the guardians of the people. But then, Jesus wanted his disciples to take care of the people. Jesus wanted his disciples to be the shepherds of his people. That's why Jesus says to his disciples, "You give them something to eat." Usually, people, we don't want to be responsible for other people's lives, right? That's the mankind. We can say, in other words, usually we are selfish. Even we are difficult to take care of ourselves, right? take care of my own life. So then how come can I really take care of other people's life? We are difficult. Well, we are selfish. We don't want, or we can't take care of other people's lives. Because I myself is difficult today. I myself is difficult. How come? How come should I take care of other people? But then Jesus wanted his disciples to take care of the people in the world. Jesus wanted his disciples to be the shepherd of many souls in this world. So you give them something to eat. Maybe God saved each one of us. God called each one of us. That we are not just, God does not just want us to live with this love of God alone for my own, for our own life. Maybe God has a similar heart. God wants us to live as a shepherd of many people in the world. Maybe God wants to maybe feed many people through his servants in this world, through the leaders in the world. You give them something to you. We need to live with this bigger love. You can say bigger love. So we want to understand the heart of God. Actually, with this love of God, we were saved, right? You are taken care of by God, by God's people. Then we also need to, God also wants to take care of many people through us. You give them something to eat. But then, as we use all our like ability and money, then would we be beggar from tomorrow? But here, the story is not like that. Verse 17. And they says to him, "We have here only 5 loaves and 2 fish. Maybe they could only find his small food, the 5 loaves and 2 fish. Maybe they brought all they have for now. They could find all they have for now. 5 loaves and 2 fish. Then verse 18, Jesus said, "Bring them here to me." Then he commanded the multitude to sit down on the grass. And he took the 5 loaves and 2 fish, and looking up to heaven, he blessed and broke and gave the loaves to the disciples, and the disciples gave to the multitude. So they all ate and were filled, and they took up 12 baskets full of the fragments that remained. So as Jesus told his disciples, "You bring that 5 loaves and 2 fish. And then Jesus blessed. Jesus prayed God with that small food. Then when Jesus prayed God, and when Jesus distributed, when the disciples distributed according to Jesus' guidance, then with that small food, then so many people could be filled. So many people could be filled. So maybe we need to bring that 5 loaves and 2 fish before God. And then maybe God will, as God bless our small offering a small time, the small things for our life, then God will feed so many people through our small things from our life. Don't think that we are great. We can feed so many people. Actually, we are small. We are weak. Even we are poor, physically. We are unable people. But then, even God feeds so many people through us. As we come before God, or as we bring our five breads and two fish. As God bless our offering, as God bless our determination, then God will feed so many people through us. God will feed 5,000 people through our offering, through our small sacrifice. Then God will feed, God will save so many people. So we want to understand the heart of God through our life. You give them something to you. But firstly, we need to remember that God saved each one of us. Through His sacrifice, through the sacrifices of the disciples of Jesus, through the sacrifices of the servants of God, then we could be saved. We could be guided to God. We could receive the eternal life. And then, as we are growing in God, then maybe God also wants to do similar things for our life. Similar things. You give them something. But then, with the five bread and two fish, we cannot really feed that 5,000 people. But then, even though it's small, but when we bring it to God, then as Jesus blessed it, then even with that small, then so many people could be filled. So God wants to look at this one. What do you have? What do you have? Bring it. Then I will use it for the kingdom of God. I will use it for the kingdom of God. You give them something to it. We need to grow. We need to grow with a bigger love. We need to grow with a bigger love. You give them something to it. John chapter 21. The book of John chapter 21. This is after Jesus died on the cross, then after Jesus resurrected. At the time, all the disciples, they went back to the world because their teacher died. Sometimes Jesus appeared to them, but then they got not really something for their life. It's like imaginary. Jesus' resurrection was just looked to be imaginary. So then all His disciples, they went back to the world. They went back to the sea to catch the fish for their life. But then Jesus went back to them. Jesus called them again. Jesus called them again. And then Jesus showed them another miracle. You throw your net at the right side. John chapter 21, front part. You throw your net at the right side, then they could catch a lot of fish. Then they could realize then John was the one, the first one who could realize then, that is Jesus. John, not the John the Baptist, the Apostle John. He realized that person is Jesus. And then they could meet Jesus again. That's how Jesus wanted to recover His disciples. So, the disciples of Jesus, they could meet Jesus again. Then maybe they could recover their faith again by Jesus. And then after Jesus welcomed them for the breakfast, and then after the breakfast, then Jesus asked Peter, Simon, son of Jonah, here, son of Jonah, verse 15, do you love me more than this? And Jesus was asking Peter, son of Jonah, do you love me more than this? And then, how did Peter reply? Yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Then what did Jesus, how did Jesus reply? Feed my lambs. Do you love me? Feed my lambs. Actually, Jesus wanted to recover the love of Peter first, the love of Peter toward Jesus. Because Peter denied Jesus three times. It looked to be Peter's faith failed, right? Yeah, Peter's faith failed. But then here, Jesus came back to them. Then Jesus wanted to recover their faith, recover their love. So do you love me? Do you love me? But at this time, Peter could not really say that I love you. Because I love you means with my will, I love you. But then it's not sure. Before then, he was always saying that I really love you. Even I can die with you. Even though Peter says like that, but then could Peter keep his word? Keep his own word? Peter could not even keep his word. That's why maybe Peter could say it this way. Instead of saying that I love you, but Peter said to Jesus, yes, Lord, you know that I love you. And even Peter could not be sure of himself. He could not be sure of himself. But then, maybe Peter still loved Jesus. But then, Peter said then, you know that I love you. You know that I love you. Actually, this is great word. Actually, we cannot believe in ourselves. We should not believe in ourselves. Well, we cannot believe in ourselves. We are weak. Or we are stupid. We think that we are strong, but we need to know that. We need to realize that we are weak. Even we can be, even maybe we can be also betraying. We can deny Jesus. But then, if we really live, believing God, depending on God, then even though we can fall down, but we can rise up again with the power of God. That's how we can say Peter and Iscariot Judas was different. Iscariot Judas, yeah, maybe he never recognized that he was a great sinner before God. I think he was living depending on himself, depending on his own righteousness. But then when he realized how he was bad, how he was ugly, so ugly, then he could not really rise up. Because he was already destroyed by himself. But then Peter, yeah, the weight of the sin was somehow different. But then anyway, even though Peter, he commits sin. But then before then he realized how he was a sinner. Then even this sinner, Jesus saved me. Jesus called me. That's why even though he denied Jesus. But then he realized, still I am a sinner. But then still Jesus, God wants to save me. God wants to forgive me. That's why he could rise up again. Peter, at least he had this faith. With the grace of God, I can live. But then Iscariot Judas, maybe he could never realize this. With the grace of God, he can live. He didn't have this kind of experience before. That's why when he fell, he could not rise up. He could not rise up. But Peter, even though he failed, he denied Jesus three times. But then when Jesus came back to him, then when Jesus recovered his faith, his love and faith toward Jesus, Simon Peter, do you love me more than this? Said, yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Then Peter asked him, feed my lambs. That is the will of Jesus through the life of Peter. Feed my lambs. How can he, if we love God, how can he really give the love back to God? Yeah, we need to take care of the people. We need to take care of the lambs and the sheep in this world. Tie the people. That's how we can give the love back to God. So Jesus talked with Peter three times. Simon, son of John, do you love me? Jesus asked him again. Then tend my sheep. Verse 16. Yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Then Jesus told him again, tend my sheep. And verse 17 again, Simon, son of Jonah, do you love me? Jesus asked him three times. Why? We are not sure. Because Peter denied Jesus three times? Well, we are not sure. Anyway, Jesus asked Peter three times, Simon, son of Jonah, do you love me? Then Peter was very worried, very sad. Yes, but then still he said to Jesus, replied to Jesus, yes, you know that. You know all things. You know that I love you. Then feed my sheep. Feed my sheep. So that was the heart of Jesus toward Peter, Peter's life. So as we live the life of Jesus, the life of faith, then we can also think about it. What can be the heart of God? What can be the will of God for our life? God saved us. God saved us. Jesus said for our life. And then maybe God also wants to feed many people through our life of faith. So you want to think about this. But is it that then, as we are feeding many people over our ability, then we can be beggar from tomorrow? 12 baskets of food could be remaining. We can see, right? We could see. 12, the remaining food was full of, it was filling 12 baskets. Why is it 12 baskets? 12 disciples. Even they could live abundantly. It was not that they got miserable from tomorrow as they were using all their possessions and money to feed many people. Then they could become very shabby, very miserable from tomorrow. Even yesterday, the praising leader, he said about the story of the Zarephath, the widow at Zarephath. Then Elijah told the Zarephath, the widow at Zarephath, then, you serve me first, right? You serve me first. If that woman didn't serve Elijah first, then what could be happening? Maybe as she said, she could be found dead the next day. The news at the village, then they could have that kind of article. A woman, a widow, and her son died at her house. It was found at her house. Maybe that news could be coming out from the village. The news of Zarephath. If she didn't really feed that Elijah at that time. But then, as she fed Elijah, believing in Jesus, God's word through the prophet Elijah, then the God's word could be fulfilled. Then she didn't die. The flow of Jar, it did not be dried up. The oil at the jug, the flour is not used up. The oil is not be dried up. So don't worry. Believe in God. You saw me first. You would not die. That is the message of Elijah. Believe in God. You would not die. God will provide for you. You give them something to eat. Huh? Even though you bring it that your food for your lunch today, but you would not be starving. You would not be starving. Full of 12 baskets, food was remaining. 12 baskets. Even you will eat a lot. You will eat a lot. Your life will be abundant. So believe in God. Huh? Believe in God and you give them something to eat. Welcome. You give them something to eat. You want to remember this. But then this is not the message of Jesus like cursing. Huh? But then Jesus wanted to bless many people. Even Jesus wanted to bless his also disciples. You give them something. And then many people could be fed. And even the disciples, they could eat, they could enjoy with abundant food. That's how God wants to bless each other. Even God also wants to bless this world through our life of faith. At this time, as you remember this story, I hope the similar miracles would be happening through our life of faith. The similar miracles. Even though we are small, we are not able, but as we bring that small bread and fish, then through our sacrifice with faith, then many people could be fed, even we ourselves, we can be enjoying delicious food today, yesterday, cookies, and then another cookies came. You are so surprised. That woman brought 3 packs of cookies, 3 packs. Very somehow expensive cookies. Oh, really? Yesterday was the day of cookies. I was somehow surprised. Is it the way of God, like providing for us, blessing us? Anyway, as we believe in God, as we live with faith, we want to know the heart of God for our life. If we just try to live ourselves, maybe we can die with it, like the Zarephath woman. If we just try to eat ourselves, then maybe we could be dying tomorrow at the news of Zarephath. A widow and the son died. Then, as she could believe in the God's word through prophet Elijah, then she could survive from the great drought, starvation, for the Israelites. The same, you give them something to eat. We want to remember this. But then this is to bless our life. This is to also bless many people through us. So, as we remember this, as we continue to live with faith, then through our life, we also want to experience the same miracle through our life of faith. So we are ending here, let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for allowing us this time to meditate your word. As Jesus came to this world, as Jesus had the great compassion looking at many people in this world, and then Jesus wanted to save, guide many people with the true word of God, with the great power of God, healing power of God for their life. And then as you saved each one of us, as you guided each one of us, then we, God also wants us to live as a shepherd, as a guide, as a teacher, as a priest for this world. So then we want to realize how God saved us, how Jesus sacrificed for our life. And as Jesus sacrificed, then we also want to sacrifice ourselves. And as we also give something small, but then as we give out something small, 5 bread, 2 fish, but then through our sacrifice, then God will also feed many people. And then we will be also filled again by great hand of God. So that as we live with faith, we want to remember your great grace for our life from God, through the sacrifice of Jesus Christ. As we also live as a disciple of Jesus, we also want to live following his sacrificial life. As we give something to the people, then we will be also filled. We will also experience the great abundance in God. And then through our life of faith, many people can also meet God. Many people can be saved. So as we meditate this word, as we continue to live with faith, we hope that then the similar miracles happening again and again through our life of faith. So thank you for all your grace through this time. And I pray all this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you all.